Okay, good afternoon students. See, in the last class we have discussed about that simple permanent tissues. Simple permanent tissues. Now see that another type of permanent tissues, that is the complex permanent tissues. We already know the permanent tissues can be divided into mainly two types. One is the simple permanent tissues and one is the complex permanent tissues. Yes, sir. See students, we already understand about the simple permanent tissues. But now there is a new concept, that is what? The complex permanent tissues. Complex permanent tissues. See students, the complex permanent tissues are made up of more than one type of cells. More than one type of cells. The complex permanent tissue is a type of permanent tissues. The complex permanent tissues is the type of permanent tissues. So these complex permanent tissues are made up of more than one type of cells. It means the different kinds of the tissues or different kinds of the cells are joined together or perform the same type of functions. But you can see in the complex permanent tissues, the different kinds of the cells are there. This is why the complex permanent tissues are made up of more than one type of cells. More than one type of cells. See students, all these cells it means what? The different kinds of cells. They perform and they coordinate to perform a common function. Perform a common function. It means in the complex permanent tissues, it has different kinds of cells, but they perform common functions. They perform common functions. So this is the complex permanent tissues. This is what? Complex permanent tissue. Dear students, one more time, see, the complex permanent tissues is a type of permanent tissues. Type of permanent tissues. It is a plant tissues. It is occur in only plants. Only plants. The complex permanent tissues are made up of more than one type of cells. It means in the complex permanent tissues, you can see the different kinds of cells. Different kinds of cells. Dear students, these all cells coordinate. They perform the common functions. Common functions. So this is about the complex permanent tissues. This is about the complex permanent tissues. Next, you see in the complex permanent tissues there are two types. One is the xylem and the one is the phloem. A very important concept, like xylem and phloem. The xylem is a type of complex permanent tissues. The xylem is a type of complex permanent tissue. Complex permanent tissue is a type of permanent tissue. Clear? The permanent tissue is a type of plant tissue. Yes, sir. So, first of all, the plant tissue can be divided into how many types? Two types. One is the meristematic tissues. Another one is what? Permanent tissues. Clear? Leave that meristematic tissue. Now, see the permanent. Permanent tissue can be divided into how many types? Two types. One is the simple permanent tissue and the other one is the complex permanent tissue. We already understand about it. Simple permanent tissue. Now see the complex permanent tissue. In the complex permanent tissue, you can see again two types. One is the xylem and the other one is the phloem. Hear all of it? Yes. See, xylem. Xylem is a type of permanent tissues. Xylem is a type of permanent tissues. And it is also known as what? Water conducting tissues. They are also known as what? Water conducting tissues. The students now see xylem. The xylem, it consists of tracheas. It consists of tracheas. After this class, I will send that related videos about the xylem, about the phloem, about the complex permanent tissue. Okay? See students, and also I will send that some pictures and charts also. Don't worry. It consists, which one? The xylem. What is the xylem? Xylem is a type of complex permanent tissue. Clear? You know, I'll be telling you about the complex permanent tissue. Yes, sir. So, xylem is is a type of complex fermented tissues. It consists, which one? The xylem is consists what? Tracheas. What? Tracheas. And also vessels. And what? Vessels. And xylem-parenchyma. Xylem-parenchyma. Don't confuse it. It is a xylem-parenchyma. Not that simple fermentation parenchyma. Clear? Yes. Xylem-parenchyma and the xylem-fibers. And the xylem-fibers. These are the main cells that are present in the xylem. But the cells have thick walls. The cells have thick walls. So this is about the xylem. So first of all we see what is xylem. The xylem is a type of complex fermented tissues. And also it has consists of the tracheas and the vessels and the xylem parenchyma and the xylem fibers. Four things. One is what? Tracheas. One is what? Tracheas. Next one is the vessels. Next one is what? Vessels. Third one is what? Xylem parenchyma. Third one is what? Xylem parenchyma. And fourth one is the xylem fibers. The four important groups are in the xylem. Parts are there in the xylem. Which one? First one is the tracheas. Second one is the vessels. Third one is the xylem parenchyma. And fourth one is the xylem fibers. These are the main components are present in the xylem. These are main four components are present in the xylem. Clear about it? And these cells have thick walls. These cells have thick walls. Which one? The xylem cells. Xylem cells. It has thick walls. Clear enough? Okay. See students, this function, what is the function of the xylem? See, it helps. Which one? The xylem. The xylem helps the conduction of water. Conduction of water and the minerals. Conduction of water and the minerals. These are all parts of the bodies. These are all parts of the bodies. Which cloud is plants. So this is the xylem. This is what? Xylem. Clear about it? Clear about it? Okay, all of understand about xylem. Next, see the xylem is helps to the conduction of water. It means what? It is the conduction of water and the minerals. And the minerals in the plant bodies, the water is flow from one place to another place, one part to another part within the plant bodies. The tank, the plants use it and which one? That is xylem. Which tissues? It is a complex fermented tissue, especially xylem. With the help of the xylem. It means with the help of the tracheas, with the help of the vessels, with the help of the xylem parenchyma, with the help of the xylem fibers. The xylem is conducting the water to all parts of the plant bodies. So this is about the xylem. Clear enough? So xylem is a type of complex fermented tissues. It consists of the tracheas. One is very important, the tracheas. Next one is the vessels. Third one is the xylem parenchyma. And the fourth one is the xylem fibers. So these are the main components are in the xylem. By using these things, the xylem tissues. Is conduct the water to the all parts of the plant bodies. We supply the water to the each and every part within the plant bodies. Clear of it? The water is moved from one part to another part. With the help of the xylem. So this is about the xylem. So the xylem is also known as what? Water conductive tissue. It's very important for every animal examination. The xylem is also for what? Water conductive tissues. Clear enough? So this is about the xylem. Next one you can see, there is a phloem. What is that? Phloem. So what do you mean by phloem? The phloem is also type of complex ferment tissues. It is also type of complex ferment tissues. As you have seen. But phloem is a food conducting tissue. It is a food conductive tissues. But xylem is a water conductive tissue. But phloem is a food conductive tissues. The phloem is also type of complex permanent tissues. Phloem is also type of complex permanent tissues. Dear students, now see the phloem consists of cell tubes and companion cells and the phloem parenchyma and the phloem pyrus. How the xylem has some components, some specialized parts. As you have seen, the phloem also has specialized things. What are those? Cell tubes and the companion cells and the phloem parenchyma and the phloem pyrus. As you have seen, you can see the xylem pyrus, as you know, phloem pyrus. Xylem parenchyma, phloem parenchyma. Clear enough? But you can see the tracheas and the vessels in the phloem. In the xylem, but you can see in the phloem, cell tubes and companion cells. Clear enough? Yes, students, please. See, phloem fibers. The phloem is a type of complex permanent tissue. It's a type of complex permanent tissues, and it is also for what? Food conducting tissue. It is also for what? Food conducting tissue. The phloem consists. The phloem consists of cell tubes and companion cells and phloem parenchyma and phloem fibers. The phloem fibers and the phloem parenchyma and the cell tubes and companion cells, these all are present in only phloem tissues. In only phloem tissue. The phloem is a type of complex permanent tissue. And also the phloem is called food conductive tissue. Why you call it as a food conductive tissues? Because the phloem tissues, the phloem cells, it conducts the food material to all parts of the plant bodies. To all parts of the plant bodies. How the xylem is conduct the water molecules within the plant bodies? As you were saying, the phloem is also conduct the food to all parts of the plant bodies. How the xylem is supplied to the water, to the all parts. As you have seen, the phloem is also supplied to food to the all parts. The all parts. With the help of the phloem tissues, with the help of the phloem tissues, the plants is supplied, the plants is supplied the food material. So that's why the plant, the phloem are called as what? Food conductive tissue. So that's why the phloem is called what? Food conductive tissues. The phloem transports the food materials to the other parts of the plants. Other parts of the plants. So this is about the phloem. So this is about the, from the combination of the xylem and the phloem, that is called vascular bundle. It means in the vascular bundle you can see only two things. One is the xylem and the other is the phloem. That is what? The combination of the xylem and the phloem. That is what? Vascular bundle. For example, in your examinations, write a short note on vascular bundle. That time you write both things. One is the xylem and the other is the phloem. Clear enough? That is a vascular bundle. That is a vascular bundle. Clear enough? Okay. So this might be the plant tissues is completely. Okay. In the plant tissue, we already understand there are two types. One is the meristematic and the other one is the permanent. We already understand about the meristematic also. Meristematic is present in the growing region. That's all it is. The meristematic tissues, it is only responsible for the growth of a plant bodies. The meristematic tissues can be divided into three types: apical, lateral, intercalary. Clear all of you? The apical meristematic tissues is present in the tip portion. The intercalary meristematic tissues is present in the middle portion, and lateral meristematic tissues are present in the girth portion. We know already. Next one is the permanent. Permanent tissue can be divided into two types. One is a simple permanent and one is a complex permanent. So these steps will be understand about the both simple permanent tissues as well as the complex permanent tissues. Now see, that is the animal tissues. Animal tissues. Dear students, so compare with the plants, the animal tissues are entirely different. So compare with each and every organisms. A lot of differences are observed. Yes, sir. But when you see the animal tissues, so compare with that animal tissue to the plant tissues, the animal tissues are entirely different. You also feel so many times. Yes, sir. So when you take the oxygen, when you release the carbon dioxide. See, when you take the oxygen, when you release the carbon dioxide, yes sir, the muscle will be contract and relaxation. It shows that your chest place. Yes sir, yes sir. You can see in our bodies the time during the movement, the time the muscles are contracted and relaxation. When you observe that body movements, so that time the muscles, in the sense what, the tissues are doing the main role in the body movements. The tissues are doing main role in the playing the very main role in the body movements. We know already. What do you mean by tissues? Group of cells. The clusters of cells. We know already. What do you mean by cell? The cell is a fundamental unit of life. So cell is responsible for structure and function of an organism. Cell is responsible for structure as well as function of an organism. So that's why the group of cells, it means the clusters of cells. That is called what? Tissues. The time, the group of cells become a tissue. Yes or no? So in the tissue, in the sense what? In the tissue you can see the cells. Same or different. But the cells are coordinate. And also the cells perform a common functions. Yes or no? Dear students, you can see in the animal tissues, there are two types. One is the epithelial and the other is what? Connective tissues. Connective tissues. Dear students, you can see in your bodies, each and every part. In your bodies, each and every part is made up of cells. Nothing but tissue. Each and every part is made up of different kinds of tissues. Different kinds of tissues has a different type of the cells, different type of the clusters of the cells. Yes or no? So these type will be, you can see in our bodies, it depends on the cells. Our bodies depends on cells. For what? For what? Structurally and functionally, the cell is responsible. Structurally and functionally, the cell is responsible. See students, the first of all, you can see in animal tissues, first one is the epithelial tissues. Epithelial tissues, in the animal tissues. So, epithelial tissues are the types of animal tissues. Epithelial tissues are the types of animal tissues. So, these one is the squamous epithelial tissues. One is the squamous epithelial tissues. And another one is what? Cubital epithelial tissues. cubital epithelial tissues. Next one is the columnar epithelial tissues. Columnar epithelial tissues. Last one is the glandular epithelial tissues. So these type we can see four types in the epithelial tissue. You can see four types in the epithelial tissue. So what is epithelial tissue? Epithelial tissue is a type of animal tissues which is present, which is covered the whole parts of the bodies. Each and every part in our bodies is covered with the epithelial tissues. It's covered epithelial tissues. Dear students, and also it is present in the mouth portion and esophagus. The lining of the mouth portion and esophagus and epithelial tissues are the lining of the kidney tubules and also salivary glands. Not only these things, but each and every parts, the each and every things is covered with the epithelial tissues. Covered with the epithelial tissues, and also it is in the intestine columnar. It has in the respiratory tract, can take any kinds of internal organs. Can take any kinds of the internal organs. These all organs, all parts is covered with the epithelial tissues. Covered with the epithelial tissues. So first of all, we can see, and also it is like epithelial tissues work like a transport. Basically, it is exchanging the waste material, exchanging the materials from inside body to the outside the bodies by through the epithelial tissues. By through the epithelial tissues, for example, the sweat. The sweat is released outside the body too, by through the epithelial tissues. Like a permeable type. Like a permeable type, it's for which one? Epithelial tissues. Epithelial tissue. See, the epithelial tissue can be divided into four types. One is the squamous. First one is what? Squamous. Squamous epithelial tissues are the types of epithelial tissues. It is a type of epithelial tissues. This is present in the lining of mouth. Lining of the mouth and the esophagus. Lining of the mouth and the esophagus. Which one? Squamous epithelial tissues. The squamous epithelial tissues are the type of epithelial tissues. These are present in the lining of the mouth and the esophagus. Esophagus. Clear of you? So this is about the squamous epithelial tissue. Okay. Next one. That is the cubital epithelial tissues. Cubital epithelial tissues. Cubital means what? That tissues are looking like tube-like structures. That is a tube-like structures. The cubital epithelial tissues are the types of epithelial tissues. But in these are present in the lining of the kidney tubules. Lining of the kidney tubules and the salivary glands. And the salivary glands. The cubital epithelial tissues are the types of epithelial tissues. These look like a tube-like structures. And in the these are present in the lining of the kidney tubules. Lining of the kidney tubules and the salivary glands. And the salivary glands. So this is about the cubital epithelial tissue. Cubital epithelial tissue.
Cilia means what? It is like
hair-like projection, which is attached in the columnar epithelial tissues. Columnar epithelial tissue. It is a lining of the respiratory tract. It is a lining of the respiratory tract. Which one? It is a columnar epithelial tissue. The columnar epithelial tissues are the types of epithelial tissues in the intestine. In the intestine and the columnar epithelial tissues with the cilia. Cilia is a hair-like projection. It is present in the attached to the columnar epithelium. And in the lining of the respiratory tract. It is present in the lining of the respiratory tract. Which one? It is a columnar epithelial tissues. Columnar epithelial tissues. The columnar epithelial tissues, it has cilia. So that's why it is called columnar epithelial ciliated tissues. Clear all of you? Okay. See. Next one, that is glandular epithelial tissues. It is also known as what? Stratified epithelial tissues. Stratified means what? Glandular epithelial tissues. Clear all of you? The glandular epithelial tissues are the types of epithelial tissues. It's a type of epithelial tissues in the glands. As in the specially functions as a gland cells which can secrete at the epithelial surface. Secrete the epithelial surface. And also these glandular epithelial tissues has more layers, like a pattern, like a pattern type. So it has a more layers. Which one? It is a glandular. It also known as what? Stratified epithelial tissues. And also in these glands, as in the special functions, has the glands cells which can secrete at the epithelial surface. It secretes at the epithelial surface. And also these has which one? The stratified epithelial tissue. It means the glandular epithelial tissue has a more number of layers. More number of layers. So this is about the glandular epithelial tissue. So this is about the epithelial tissues only. Okay. But in exam time, you will ask only 2 months. What is epithelial tissue? Write their types. As otherwise, you write only one point. You get full marks. It means 3 marks question. Epithelial tissues. Write about the epithelial tissues. Okay. Next one is a connective tissue. I'll continue next class. Connective tissue. Okay. So today we are all of understand that which one there is a complex filament tissues. In the complex filament tissue, we understand about the xylem and the function and what is a phloem. The functions, and today we understand there is animal tissues. In the animal tissues, we understand about that their types, what is the epithelium and the connective tissues. In the epithelium tissues, we can see that the 4 types: squamous epithelial tissues, tubular epithelial tissues, and the columnar epithelial tissues, and the glandular epithelial tissues. Okay, you write it all times. The time you got information about the epithelial tissues. Okay, so this is about the today class. I'll continue next class. Thank you so much. Okay.